We have now found that consumption of artificial sweeteners, especially sucralose, which is hidden in a variety of different drinks and foods, is associated with worse overall response and progression-free response in cancer patients receiving immunotherapy.
Dr. Abby Overacre was the lead author on the study published today in Cancer Discovery, a publication of the American Association for Cancer Research. Her team at the University of Pittsburgh and UPMC Hillman Cancer Center was able to link the artificial sugar sucralose with disruptions in the gut microbiome, which they say depleted arginine, an amino acid that is critical for T cell activity, the immune cells that help cancer therapies work.
There were some studies that came out previously that showed that artificial sweeteners can have a negative impact on your gut microbiome. And we know from previous patient data that your gut microbiome is critically important for response to immunotherapy.
Dr. Overacre put that to the test by feeding mice treated with immunotherapy sucralose. Her lab found their tumors grew and they had poorer survival rates. But here was the hope. They also found adding arginine supplements, which are widely available, restored the immune system's ability to fight cancer.
Had mice that were consuming sucralose, and then we just supplemented in arginine or citrulline to boost that amino acid. And what we found is that that worked just as well as if we took them off sucralose completely.
Citrulline is another easy to find supplement that's metabolized into arginine in the body. The researchers also studied real cancer patients undergoing immunotherapy. Using detailed food surveys, her team found a strong correlation between patients consuming artificial sweeteners and worse immunotherapy outcomes. The team is now planning clinical trials to test arginine supplements in human cancer patients, hoping to get the same T cell benefit they saw in mice.
They looked less exhausted and they were able to exert their function and kill tumors better. And so ultimately what that meant for, you know, either the mouse and then hopefully, you know, in our clinical trials is that those tumors actually went away and immunotherapy started to work again.
Isn't that amazing? Now, important to note, the study did just look at sucralose in particular, which is only one of a plethora of artificial sweeteners on the market right now. That would be the one in the yellow packet. Now, Overacre's team plans to explore the other artificial sweeteners as well, like aspartame and saccharin, and their impact on immunotherapy. So we will certainly keep following this team as they move into clinical trial.